Hello everybody and welcome to a new part in the Thylacine tutorial series. Again, it's been quite some time since the last one. Yeah, I've been busy with other stuff. University kept me occupied for the time, but I had a little time today and I figured I could you know, continue in this one a bit. So, as you can see, this is where I left off last time. The colors are all over the place. It's really inconsistent, and there are many parts with stretches or simply the wrong texture, and there are some seams, and it's really quite ugly at the moment. So we have to do something to fix it all up. And I suppose the first thing I do would be to go over the colors again, especially work on the head to get that one nice and clean. So first we need a reference. I figured we could take this one because it has a nice dark colors and the pelt isn't faded. We'll just, come on, drop it here. And scale it. Just so I have access to it whenever I need the colors. So I can sample them easily. And just so it doesn't bother me as much, I can remove background. Well, and this border annoys me. Layer to image size. Yeah. Alright, so now I'll sample this color. And I'll use a sample average, because I don't want just one pixel, but I want the average of this block here, this one. Okay, so now I'll get rid of that one. I'll see where the stuff lives. Yes. So I'll just use the paintbrush and set it to color or hue. I'm not really sure what the best option was because I'm kind of rusty. I didn't do any texturing since that last tutorial, so I'll just try stuff around and see how it goes. So when I use this color brush, I only change the color, but I keep the texture intact. Now I'll try hue for a bit. I'm never quite sure what's the difference, but I think hue keeps the differences in the color intact, while when I use the color brush, it overrides the color value completely, or it blends in this case. So basically what we're doing now is remaking the color mask. And that's kind of annoying because all of these layers are still separate, so I'll just create a new layer from visible and work on that one instead. I'll still keep the others just so I have a backup. So sample again. Okay. Now, the tricky part is that I want to create consistency, but I don't want it all to have the very same color because that would be super boring and it looks quite ugly. So I need to get some different shades of color in there somehow. So I'll sample from different spots and try to use a smaller brush to give it some variety. I also used a burn tool to, oops, even out the differences in lightness, only to some extent because I don't want to remove the pattern that it originally had. Yeah, I'm sampling from the wrong layer. I could sample like that forever and get the wrong results. No wonder it doesn't look the way I want it to. Oh, yeah. So here on this pelt we see that this the top of the snout is actually quite dark, but we lack that, so I'll take the dodge tool or the burn tool again. Kind of darken it. I'll brighten this up a bit to reduce the contrast. That's already starting to look better, but it's still a long way. Then we have this dark area here, which is fairly green, so we'll use that for these dark patches here. Can use some more opacity. Now we need some red. Here's red. Yep. I'll use a smaller sample. Oops. So I think this area here could have a little more saturation because it's looks quite pale. Overall, I'll use this one again to figure out the contrast differences. So this here still has I'm not quite as much contrast as the rest. We'll increase the contrast here a bit. Now you can see this area here is way too sharp, so we have to blur it a bit to match all the rest. I think I turned the sampling off when I baked these parts for some reason, I don't know why, but it looks like there was no sampling buffer used. And usually only normally do that if you have a good reason, and in this case there was no reason. Okay, so I drove up the contrast, but doing that I also drove up the saturation, and of course I have to take that down again. Paint over the colors a bit. I'll clone over this spot here because it kind of looks very patchy. This one as well. Okay, so now there's this green bit left here. I think that should also become more red, but we'll look at the reference. Okay, it doesn't tell us anything, but we'll assume it has a similar color here to the outer here. Oops. I try to even out these shadows a little because they are often too strong to look good on the model. And I can clone over this portion here as well. Oh yeah, I have to turn on alignment. I think it's aligned. Yeah, that's the one I want. That didn't improve anything. Yeah, maybe like that. Okay, so now I think the head's more or less fine, at least really roughly. So now we could, for example, look at the nose or look at the jaw and maybe also the teeth. So I'll just look for references. So I'll go to Flickr. Now, come on. And what do we use? Maybe a qual. Yeah, well, actually, it might work as a texture reference for the eye. It could work, perhaps, and also the nose might work, and stuff like the ear might work. Another candidate. This one looks nice. I need a sort of 3/4 angle for the face texture. This one seems to be blurry. Here we have a jaw, but it's not, the mouth is not, well, it's not complete. It would be great if it had a really wide open gape. This one could be nice for the muscle and all these little bristles of the nose. We have them on the thylacine as well, but this one could work. Yeah, I think new tab. I think the Tasmanian devil should be better because they tend to open their jaws. Why is there a thylacine? Yeah, something like that. Maybe. I don't want. This one could work. I think it'll also work for the nose because the nose is black on the thylacine and not pink as on the qual. Just one problem, they always seem to curl back their tongue in this weird fashion. I'm not quite sure if I like it like that. Oh well. Ooh, ugly. Well. I suppose that'll have to do. I'm not quite sure what to use. It's always kind of tricky when you have to decide, but you don't really have good references. Dead quals. Oh, that one looks nice. But again, it's not really facing the camera, so it's only useful to some extent. Quals are actually quite cute. This one maybe, but it looks faded, yeah, low quality. Blurry. This one's also kind of blurred. And here we have only a bit. Well. What should we do? Yeah, I think I'll just go with this one. Yeah, they won't let me talk in again. Alright. So I'll just take the interesting bit. Make it fit. That's kind of annoying with GIMP because the transformation tools are really, really crude, and they're not really useful because you have to switch the mode whenever you want to scale or rotate something, and it's really quite annoying. It's a lot better in all the other programs I've worked with, but that's really one of the only points where it's really lacking. Okay, so I'll use the eraser tool a little to blend it in. Yeah. Well, I guess it's about time we'll have a look how it looks on the model. This is merge number 2. Yeah. So, got to open up Blender again. I hope I can work with it, because my middle mouse wheel kind of died, and I'm having a hard time holding it down yet I'm having trouble rotating the model. Well, it'll have to do somehow. In the worst case, I can still use the keyboard to look around the model, but of course it's not nice. Yeah, that's kind of... the head has gotten a lot better, but of course yeah, the jaw is quite ugly because we don't have the UV grid to align. Yeah, I'm kind of lazy here. But that's really not much of a difficult task here to line this up. So it also works if you don't have the UV grid. This still looks ugly because of the way the teeth are pictured here. Well, I guess I'll have a look at the nose first, because that seems to be easier. So, Let's take one of these quals. Maybe this one. Oh, it's low resolution again. So this one perhaps. It's also so small. Yeah. Yeah, maybe like that. This is also really annoying that you can't match the stuff up properly, because you can't hide the grid, or at least, oh, you can, you can't change the transparency of it. You can't adjust it. Oops. Okay. So just make it match with a fairly crude method. Which is simply by taking the different parts and make them match. Just trying things. To blend it into the rest. Let's see if it looks any better. Yeah, it does give it some kind of consistency. Of course, it didn't fix the issue on the nose, because it's simply stretched here. So we'll have to smooth that out first. Just draw the basic pattern of the nose I want. And look at my ref again. Yes, I don't get the wrong kind of shape for the snout or for the nose. Overlay. Yeah. Just try how I see it. That looks. Oops. Yeah, I didn't get the right spot, but I'll just edit the UV map. Because I think that looks wrong like that. Have to look at some specimens again. It does seem to have this sort of slanted curve here at the nose. I need more. Not so much here. Don't really have a reference for the front view. I do. And a gray. It's too dark to see anything. But oh yeah. I can clearly tell my model needs to be wider in this place here. I think the nose looks too much like that of a dog. I'm not quite sure what the problem exactly is, but I think I'll figure it out sometime. Well, more painting here. So the nose seems to connect to the lip, but it's really hard to tell. And here in this one, the muscle seems to be... No, it's also quite wide, actually. I think for some reason I made it too narrow here. It seems to have a fairly round tip of the nose. It's not quite as spiky as it was before. But I still think this bit here is a slight bit too thin. Yes, I think now it's about right. Nope. This here is too thick. Yeah, I like that better. So I'll save that one. Okay, so the head looks quite cool actually, at least the upper bit, and of course it still needs lips. Yeah, the qual doesn't help here, and the devil doesn't really help a lot either, but oh. This one maybe, or that one, or this one. I thought everybody would take pictures when they open their mouth, but apparently they don't always do that. This one is quite good because it's almost the same angle as on the skin. I hope it's... Yes, it's in high resolution. That's great. That's all we need. Yeah, but now I really, really need this UV map. I can't do it without. So I just, I'll create one. Because you go nuts if you always try to align it and you always fail because it, you never quite get it right just by looking. Yeah. And the huge problem is also that you can't scale and resize at the same time. So you basically lose quality quite quickly. Nope, not multiply overlay. No, hard light. Just keep it on normal. So it gives us a lot of consistency, but at the price or at the cost of reducing accuracy, because it looks like a hybrid, really, because it's too red and this dark edge around the lip doesn't fit. So I'll see if I can get rid of that. I'm not sure if it's possible. And these long bristles here, they also break the pattern. They don't go well with the rest. Even though we have some bristles here around the eye, they are not as big. So it looks like the mouth will become something I'll have to paint. Maybe it could be sourced from some other species. I'm not quite sure about that yet. But for the moment, this solution should at least get it going somewhere that we can use it as an inspiration for to compare things and to see what works, what doesn't work. It's still too pink, but I think here it works quite well, and here it starts to not really work anymore, or it stops to work. I'll just blur this portion here on the main skin layer so I can blend in the other stuff more easily without getting these artifacts here back. And this one too. Because when I have these artifacts in the background, I can't blend it in. At least if they're really crisp, it just doesn't work. Yes, I think that looks a lot more convincing now. It's certainly not perfect yet, but it's a sort of a blueprint of where it could be going. Because we have this nice flow of the lip curve here, and the bristles work well all the way along. Now, of course, the texture is not in place, and this one's really raw here on the lower jaw, but yeah, that can be fixed with some overlaid layers or anything really. That's not much of a big deal. And at some point we also have to add teeth. Yeah, so we might just as well do that now. If we're already in Blender. This one. So we have these short teeth in the front, the long fangs, and short teeth in the back, and we can reduce the model to that as well. Of course, we have the same structure on the lower jaw. Yeah, and here I was kind of lazy again. I just didn't know better. Because of course, when you look at the jaw, The tongue usually sticks out, and this is something I usually overlooked in the past. And it's sort of a general problem. You always tend to make the lower jaw too weak and too thin, when actually the tongue often sticks out, and the lips and the gum and all of that stuff make it actually quite thick and almost massive, at least a lot more massive than you would assume it to be just from looking at the bones. So we gotta put these somewhere. I pin all this stuff before I break it. And then of course unpin these and unwrap. Assign to the texture. Now roughly have to find the same texture size. Make normal's face out. Yeah. Yeah, that looks about right. It doesn't really matter if they're exactly the same size. We'll just put them down here because we might need this UV space here for something later on. You never know. Yeah, well, it's definitely slowly getting there. Okay, we need the new UV map. Can save that. I think something's broken with my GIMP because I can't drag the layers up or down anymore. Something's definitely broken. I have no clue what it is. Well, obviously we now need the teeth, and we have to get them from somewhere. Gee, these are ugly. I think going from the skull might be easier. Let's see if we can find some. Yeah, that's one. Yeah, but it's difficult to separate it. To create the alpha mask because of it's not against a plain white background. Maybe this one would be nice. This here's a better angle. A lot of crazy stuff always. Yeah, you can always count on those Bible dudes because they always try to. Ah, their side died it. Evolution fairy tale. Maybe I can still get that picture. It's there again. Three. Okay. Now maybe I'll try to get another one. It's not really crisp. This one would be quite nice because it has some contrast. I might end up using it after all. Is it a dog or a thylacine? It looks like a thylacine because this tooth is quite small. Yeah, but I'll double check. Carnivora. It's so weird. Thylacine versus clouded leopard. Crazy. But at least we have our reference. Yeah, I think I'll just really quickly. No, I don't want any feathering. Just want anti-aliasing. Just really quickly draw along the edges. I have to stop. Because it's tiring. Oh no, I moved it, I think. Nope, I didn't. Did I? Well, I'll do it in smaller bits. It almost always works better this way. Because when you do it, without using these edges, you usually mess up, and because your hand is bound to tremble, and you never get those nice corners correctly. But it takes a little longer to go point by point, but it usually pays off. I'm not quite sure if the thylacine has 4 or 6 incisor teeth. I'll have to check on the skull. So 6 in the lower jaw, 8 in the skull. Wait. Thylacine is red. 8. Yeah. So maybe. But I think, yeah, the resolution is too small. Oh, but here it could work. No, I'll just look for another one. These are all sort of ugly. That's the same one. That's a hyena. Haven't seen this one before. Now, oh, come on. Please, image check. Great. Oh well. Anyway, I'll just put. Oops. These together. It's of course not the absolutely best way to solve this issue, but it goes fairly quickly and easily, so it's tempting. I always forget it doesn't work like that here. Yeah, well, now we have the skull teeth. So Now, of course, we don't have the gum here. So again, we have to do some guessing game. And then reconstruct the gum and add it onto that. Yeah, of course, that looks fairly ugly at the moment. So I'll just go the quick and easy way and make a UV map match. Because making the other stuff match is always quite painstaking. I can also edit the model a little, at least where it seems to be right to do so. Oh no, have to go back there. And now they look about right, but we see too much of the fangs. Even if we account for the gum, we see too much and has to go further inward. So that's always quite tricky to figure out how much of the teeth you want to show, especially when you go about stuff like dinosaurs where you don't have a living reference. But the general consensus today seems to be that the lips always cover the teeth, at least when the mouth is closed, so you would never have normal teeth sticking out of the mouth, but tusks are an exception. So things like boar or I don't know, musk deer, stuff like that, and elephants. So, but in general, in predators, you will always have the teeth covered by the lips. Yes, so I'll just take the paint tool, wrong layer again, I'll just take the paint tool and I'll just merge this down. Paint gum onto this layer. No, first I'll increase the contrast, then I'll add gum. Now that was stupid, I should have done that before I merged it, so I'll go back. increase contrast and brighten and darken it a bit. Make it less intense, something like that. And because these bones, or when you have casts of these skulls, they are usually bleached, so they are a lot whiter than what you'd find in a living animal, because they are always dirty. Okay. Now when we paint the gums, we try to approximate their actual position. So a lot of the teeth is really covered in gum, and very little sticks out normally. Did it here, but the rest looks good. Now I can merge it. This is always quite a tricky task to get this skin tone. Right, then you also you have to make it somehow crisp, but you don't want to make it look just like noise, and you should also try to get it a little glossy. Yes, so the gum is all buried, so we can bring it out just a tiny bit more to hide the seam, so we show some of the gum texture here, and when we make it darker now, we some more here. Oh, we can reduce this seam effect quite a bit. That's pretty close. Maybe. Yeah, I think that works. Now I'll just do one thing so I can see it better, and when we switch to the Blender game mode, we get some extra options for the shading, and then we can set the alpha to alpha clip, and then we see the alpha like it will appear in the game, and we can also turn off backface culling, so we see both sides of the alpha. So I think we could show even a little more gum. We can also achieve that by moving this. Is it also still the gum? I have no idea. This part a bit more upward. And we can even stretch it all a little to bring out the gum. Yeah, now that's really getting there. And now it's basically the exact same procedure for the lower jaw. Yep. So I hope this one will go a little bit faster, because I figured out a good workflow. So here we have the two rows of teeth in front of each other, which makes it again a little difficult to mask them, but with some patience, and if you know how the teeth should look, you can still mask them fairly easily. It's difficult to add these incisor teeth here. I'll just take them from above and not make a big fuss about it. So I'll just take three from here. I gotta check on complete skull again. The longest teeth are, here we are, next to the canine teeth. Okay, so we got to flip the image and then we can rotate. Oops. Nah, actually don't need that. I have no clue how big or small it should be. I need my UV map once again. No, I'll just scale it so it matches the upper jaw. So we gotta bring the teeth from the skull a little bit to the side so we have some more space. For these ones here. Oops. So if you really want to go for completely accurate dentition, then you should probably do reconstruction of the skull, of the naked skull, and then add the muscles and the tissue and the skin on top of that, so you know exactly where the teeth should be on your model and how far they should go back, how big they should be, and so on, because I'm kind of doing guesswork here, or educated guesswork mostly. Ooh, it can close its jaws. And now it's beginning to feel alive, really. Doesn't look so much like a patchwork anymore. It has teeth, and of course, we see some problems here with our teeth, because, yes, the teeth or the jaw doesn't close properly. and these stick through the lower jaw. That's better. Now I think it looks a bit bulky still. But I'm not sure if that impression comes just because of these lips or if it's really general shape. I have to check some references for that. Problem is, we don't really have anything that's absolutely reliable, because all of these taxidermies, they can only give you a really rough idea, because most of the people who made these taxidermies didn't ever see a live specimen, maybe only had the pelt. They didn't even have the dead animal in front of them, they only had the naked pelt. So they did a lot of guesswork, and this is why most of these stuffed specimens look much more like a wolf or a dog rather than a thylacine. And the problem with all these vintage, the lips actually seem to be dark, but you can never quite tell, because often these images, as you can see here, have been edited to show what the author might have thought or might have considered typical. So it's really difficult after all this time, but you can clearly see the lip has to be black, so that's something I should change at some point. But first we need to add the gum. Very much the same as above, same procedure, same methods, same workflow. Where did these colors come from? I have too many layers here now. I'll delete a few I don't need anymore. I changed the order last time. I first did these darker bits and then painted over with lighter bits. So now I'm doing it the other way around again. So much to same workflow. Well, you never know. I Okay, so now we'll adjust brightness and contrast. And saturate. That's a tongue twister for me. Not so much, but it has to be a little brighter, probably. Lighter more. Not really brighter, just lighter. But the teeth should be dark, yeah. And because the lip has to be dark eventually, we don't have to brighten this up too much. Yeah, I think we can make it darker still. This one. Was too much. Now I'll try to even these differences out here a bit. And then I'll darken it here. Yeah, I think that already works. So now I'll make it dark. Give it some dark lips. And because I like the burn tool, I just use that mostly. Right layer. Seems about right. But I'll have to clean this mess up a bit before I continue. First I'll save this GIMP file because I want to have something I can go back to in case I mess up. Now I'll close it and see if I can rearrange my layers then again. Maybe, maybe not. Still no. I don't like that. Well, I'm sure there's something that keeps me from doing that, but I'm not sure what would be the reason. Oh. Now, for some reason, the burn tool gives me quite sharp edges here. I'm not sure why it does that. Because the brush that I use is supposed to have soft edges. But for some reason, it doesn't like that. Well, at least it gives me some interesting pattern to work with. It might actually work. Just like that already. Oops. Nah, it's too messy, but I think it works on the outside. Yeah, and I have to go here. Need to add more black here. Don't want any black in here. And oops. I need a lot more. Gotta look at the reference again. Benjamin. Ah, okay, look at that. Here's a huge dark spot all around here. Oops. And now I really have to merge this layer into my other layer. Oop. Well, it's not really how I wanted to do it, but it seems to work as well. No, it doesn't quite work as intended. Well, I'll just go and make a new layer from visible. It's beginning to get chaotic. So, I think that's pretty close to what I saw in that photo. Here's a spot where it shouldn't be dark yet, but the dark bit should continue. So this here should be bright. There's some kind of indent. Maybe that's closer. Yeah, I'm fairly sure it is. Hey, actually, when they open their mouth, they curl their tongue back just like the Tasmanian devil does. So that's pretty cool. Oh, we need a little black spot here as well. I'm gonna make it a little more crisp, I think. Oh yeah, and I can definitely edit the UV map a bit to save me some repainting. Yeah, but when I just look at the head, kind of seeing the whole picture now. Just noticed that the teeth here are way too small. Because they don't line up with the upper ones. Of course they have to. Yeah. Reference once again. How do the teeth end up? Okay, there's a small one on top, and yeah, I think that's about right. And it can be a little bigger, little bit bigger still. Bit more. Definitely getting there. Now I'll just see if the teeth interlock properly. So lower jaw should go in front of. Yeah. Now this one here sticks out too much. Now it's okay. And yeah, this bristle here has annoyed me for quite a while, so now it'll have to go. Or at least it'll be reduced. It's really getting there. I think that's enough for today because it's getting kind of late here. I have to get up early tomorrow because there's university on Sundays, which I always love. Yeah, so that's it for this time. So basically we went from, I'll just save that and bring up the old one for comparison again. We went from this head, which was really ugly. Absolutely no mouth definition at all, to this one, which is, while the inner mouth is still not quite there, we have the teeth and we have most of the color of the head and the basic texture in place. And so we now have to find some sort of texture to give some more detail to the top of the mouth, and also find a tongue texture. And then of course the next step will be, that wasn't clever. That was not clever at all, because I merged that pelt into my file. Ooh, yeah. Well, I can just move that one. Because all the interesting stuff has happened down below here. And yeah, now I have the interesting stuff. I somehow have to figure out why I can't rearrange the layers anymore. It used to work when I tried it earlier, but now it doesn't anymore. I have no clue why. Anyway, so that's the current state. Basically, the head is getting there slowly, so the next step would be either to finish the mouth completely, or just to go on gradually and piece everything together, give it the proper colors and fill in all the missing textures, even everything out and stuff like that. Yeah, well, see you next time, I guess.